Okay, so last episode I built the thing over there and the thing over there, and I did a little bit on the quarry over there. But now I'm going to start thinking about what am I going to start thinking about? I've totally forgotten. God's sake. All right, okay. I was going to count the amount of people. Okay, so there's one, two, three in that house, two in that house, five, six, seven, eight, nine. So we have nine people living in our town right now. And if you think about it, say you'd take three people for mining, you'd take one person fishing, two people running the farm. That is, I'm terrible at counting on my fingers. Seven. So one, two, three, four, five, six. And then say you have a woman looking after the kids, that's seven. And then one kid, eight. And then we've got one person left over to do like building, so say he's a builder. Or the father and son do the building. That would be a good idea. Basically, all the jobs are now used up, and we need to expand our settlement. We need to make this more prosperous. So we're going to need more housing. And now our family that lived in here, they've been working on this farm a while now. They're getting it on a bit, and they're learning the skills of the blacksmithing and stuff like that. Let's press H. Nope. There we go. So they're going to want a nicer house, and they're going to leave this house for the next people who are going to come along. Problem is now, when we start to expand the population, we're going to need more food, and we're starting to run a bit low. I mean, we've got the fish, we've got the crops here, but that's not quite enough to feed everyone. So obviously we're getting the animals that live in this area, which I killed last episode, but we still need to expand the farm a little bit. So I'm going to start off this episode by just doing that. And I'm going to expand it around this house, I think. No, where should I expand it? Okay, I'm going to expand it this way. It will come up to the edge of this house. So this house, if he wants to get out, he'll walk around. So we're gonna bring it back out here. Fucking bushes die horribly in fire, painfully. If you die, and I'll bring this up to say, I don't know. Will this interfere with the fire? No, it won't. Okay, so we can bring it right up to the edge of this house here. That makes sense. Sorry about that. where was I? Oh yeah, I was expanding this cottage's thing. Right, so first one needs to get rid of all this, and I'm not going to use a command for it. I can't be bothered. I'm just going to go around like this. Let's go like this. I need to replace these because I'm going to need them. Right, and now I take my wooden axe, and I need a bucket of water as well. Like that. Select that and come over here. Select that. Replace that. Now let's go around watering our flowers like this. Should be enough. One, two, three. Yeah, one, two, three. Right, so that should fully water everything. So now I'm going to do \\, replace grass with 60. I'm also going to do \\, replace gravel with 60 as well, because I've got a bit of gravel there. You can see everything's getting watered, so that's nice. And then I'm going to do this, move up our selection a little bit. Oh, I needed a hoe, didn't I? Where's my hoe? Ho ho ho. Enjoy. Right. So that's our first one selected, and then we're going to come over here and do this corner as well. Nope. Use the right tool, James. There we go. And then we're going to do \\, replace. Oh no, \\. Yeah, replace, otherwise I'm going to cut out that chimney, which I don't want to do. Replace air with crops, I think it was. There we go, crops. Now /grow. And everything should be growing. There we go, very nice. Now I'm just going to put a few torches around the field. Oh yeah, someone said stop throwing things out of your inventory. It's a habit, I'm sorry. I'll do my best, okay? God. And I'm also going to put some hay bales, because they look pretty. I'm putting these more randomly, because it's not particularly important that they have to be in rows. Kind of adds to the look of the settlement if it's a bit more sporadic. So there we go. I'm also going to build a scarecrow just because I want to. Sorry, did it again. Right, so I'm going to take a jack-o'-lantern. It's going to be a lit jack-o'-lantern. Doesn't have to be, but I want to. I'm also going to take levers and a button. Right, and I'm going to put it here. Because it's like, this place isn't going to get lit very much. So I'm going to put down two pumpkins, delete the bottom one, put down the fence, stick a button on its nose, and then two levers each at either side. There we are. I love that. Hold on, can I? Yes! It's got a hat now! Oh my god, that's so cool. I'm so sad. Right, so there's a scarecrow. Oh, isn't that cute? No. I'm also going to put a bit more lighting around here because I'm aware this is quite dark. Well, it would be if it ever actually turned to night in this mystical kingdom where the time of day keeps changing back. Put that there. In here, this is going to be lit anyway, but I might as well stick some torches. Just put some of these around. Right, it's time set. No, time and night. Okay, I need to put some light over here. I just realised I haven't actually done anything over here. Let's put a light above the doorway. And a light there, and a light there. There we go. Doesn't it look lovely? So, now what was I doing? Oh yeah, now we've got enough food to support more people. I'm going to build another house, so I'm going to build it out of wood, because obviously we've got the wood from over there, which is also there. I'm also going to build it out of, it's going to be a thatch. I just resized my game window, sort that out. How could we build our next house? I don't want it to be as big as this one, so it's going to be like this, but smaller. So it's going to have a thatch roof, wood, and then the material will be cobblestone, I reckon. And this house is going to go... See, because I want to strive away from this area, because this is kind of industrial. I think I might build it over here. I don't want to build it right next to that one, though, because that would too kind of... Because, you know, people wouldn't be worrying about space in this kind of place, would they? Because they've got so much space everywhere. I'm going to put it here. I'm going to try and replicate a cottage design that I used to build all the time. I'm not sure how it'll go, because I haven't built it for ages, but it's worth a shot. And it has a 2-block-wide window. I think all this is just cobblestone. Just think about this. 2-block-wide window, and then it has the end wall like that. And then it's got a 1-block-wide door. I think it's this shape. So as you can see, it's very small. But I think I made it like this because the roof actually looks really nice. And the doorway is at this end, so it's actually a weirdly shaped doorway as well. And then we've got two like that, and then the window will go here. Now they've got their little fire thingy up, they're actually going to be able to get some of this sand from over here in the sandbank, and they're going to be able to make some glass. So I'm going to start using glass now. I'm going to use glass panes. Oh, I keep dropping this stuff, I'm sorry. Because glass panes look awesome. Like this. Now, how did this roof go? What if I do this? Oh! Oh god. Ah! Skype just popped up. Go away! Go away! Oh, it's completely fucked up my Minecraft. Minecraft! Okay, I'm back. Hopefully I didn't just lose any of what I just said. But still. Okay, so now that would go like that. Oh, that's too low, isn't it? Right, that's too low, so it needs to go up another block. Which means that this needs to... No! Stop pushing the rubber buttons, bloody hell! Like that, and then like that, there we go. I've got such an itchy nose. Why? Why? There we go. And now the edging piece will go on like this. And if I remember correctly, it creates a nicely proportioned house, but we'll see. It might look awful. Got rid of my coal soon, didn't I? There we go. Yeah, that looks okay. And then do the rest of the roof like this. I think this is how I did it. And have a nice flat top like so. Let's go in here. There we go, that looks nice. It's nice, nicely proportioned. I'm a bit worried about the size of the windows, I think that's a bit big. Flying's turned off, so stop flying. God's sake. How could I make these windows smaller? That is the question. You see what I mean? They just look, it looks too much. Oh, let's just get rid of the bottom half and see what it looks like. It's kind of like a half window. I keep trying to walk on these crops. No, that looks weird. Okay, well, let's delete this top one then. There, that looks a lot more natural now. What would happen if I brought down the thatch a bit more? Okay, I'll leave it like that. Oh no, I just destroyed something, didn't I? There we go. Right, so here's a little cottage. Very little cottage. It's got a bit too much roof. I think it's a bit high. I'm not going to lower it though. Maybe the next cottage I build will be a bit lower. What if I kind of... It's raining! No, I guess that looks a lot more... No, it looks weird, damn it. Can't work this out. How am I supposed to do this? What if I make it look a lot more constructed like this? Ah! It's hard with a building this small. I guess I could just have one big beam across it. What if I had a beam going across here? No, there's no point in unnecessarily making it smaller. What about a beam here and here? That way I could have storage up there. Yeah, I think that works. It's a bit more homely. What about if I just did this? Do I have room for anything upstairs? No, but I could have some... I could have some, like, chests or furnaces up here, or some kind of storage, like an attic. The floor will be made out of wood. Like this. God damn it, I'm so indecisive. Okay, I'm gonna get rid of this. I'll just leave it high for now. I'll be fine. Okay, so the door will go there. You walk in here, it's all pretty, everything's nice. That should be that. Like that. And then we're gonna have a bed in that corner. Here. Chest. There. A workbench here. A furnace. Here. I still like making something out of the furnaces, because I don't think they should just be like they are at the moment. Actually, the furnace will go beside the bed. Go to that window. Furnace will go here, and I'll make something out of it, like a little fireplace or something. Where are you? There you are. Like... cobblestone. Okay. That's sort of the back of the house. And there would be the chimney. Alright, and now I need to put my bed somewhere, so I'll just put the bed, like, here. And the chest... Where's the chest gone? There you are. Chest can go there. And that's all you'd need, I guess. There's a little spacer. And now I'll put up some torches so they can see. There. And there. Need a doorway. Door. There you go. And finally, I just need a little path going to it using some gravel. I'm actually going to speed up this next bit because I'm also going to gravel all the way over to the quarry. So I'll wrap up this episode here and I will see you guys soon. Actually, quick note before I go, I thought I'd tell you about this tool as well. If you type in / replace water, tool, I use this all the time, I've forgotten how to do it though, tool, replace, and then water. Okay, and now when I click, it will turn into water, but I don't want water, so... why did I do water? I'm an idiot. Tool, replace, gravel. Okay. And now, when I right-click, I just make a little gravel path, so, yeah, I'll see you guys soon.